Taylor.
New student today. Your name, dear?
Yes. I'm Maya, yes.
Maya. Okay. Hi, Maya. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. So I haven't been able to join this time. I drive home from work at this time normally. So, yeah.
Okay. So today is your first class, right, Maya?
For this session, yes.
Okay, so could you tell me something about you, like your experience about yoga and how many years you are practicing yoga, or you are complete beginner and your expectation?
No, I've been practicing on and off probably for about the last 10 years. Yeah.
Okay. So you are just practicing the physical part of the yoga, right? The asana only.
Yeah.
And you have...
Yeah, that's correct.
Okay. Welcome to our therapy class, Maya.
Thank you. Sorry, we'll have a Labrador coming in and out.
That's okay. That's fine. I think you are any dog lovers, right?
Yes.
Good. I think how many people... students are joined. You are the only one now. We are waiting for the other students also. Let's see, they're gonna join.
Yeah, sounds good.
So Maya, meanwhile they're gonna join us. We have discussed about the Ayurveda till now. So we completed 4 or 5 lectures about it. So
yeah.
I think you can get all the videos from the YouTube.
Yeah, I've got access to that now, so that's good.
That's great. So you can follow the first session, second session, and third, fourth. And if you have, after listening it, if you get any doubts and queries, you can ask during the class.
Yeah, sounds good.
Yeah. So we are right now on the Sapta Prakriti, the title which we are, taking in this session, Sapta Prakriti, 7 types of personality, we are discussing about it. I think you heard about the Ayurveda earlier. You have a good idea about Ayurveda. Okay, good. So you heard about Vata, Pitta and Kapha, these things?
A little bit,
okay. So I have given the lecture that is recorded. Again, Zoom session, completely recorded on and available on the YouTube. Okay, so we discuss previous class. We discuss about the 7 types of personality. Like in this whole world, we have the 7 types of the personality, and Vata Pitta we discussed about it. And today we're gonna discuss more about the Kapha and the combination personality. And please pardon me, I'm a little bit sick because I get COVID positive. So I'm on the recovery stage.
Oh, I hope that recovery is going okay.
Yeah, I'm going well. And till now, everything is going very well. I'm also doing therapy on myself. I'm not taking any allopathic medicine and treating myself with the herbal medicine, and lots of home remedies.
So
maybe end of when I recovered fully, I'll discuss about it, how I come out from the COVID thing, this virus, and we discuss about how the therapy can help, especially those people who are not in the critical stage, right? And how we can prevent. We're gonna take this thing also in the class. Okay. Let me see anybody join. If you have any doubts, Maya, you can ask me related to the Ayurveda, because there is nobody from the previous class. So we can go according to you. If you want to ask me about anything related to the Ayurveda, which you want to know about it, because we discussed about the importance of the Ayurveda, why we require Ayurveda, and what is the importance of the health, purpose of the human being, and importance of the healthy being. And we discussed about the three dosha, Vata, Pitta, and Kapha, and some Agni. And now we are discussing Veg, types of Veg. We discuss about Mal, we discuss about it, and Ama. So we discuss about these things through this session.
Okay. I don't have any questions at the moment. Sorry.
So which country you belong to?
Australia.
Wow, one of my friends, she is in Sydney.
Oh, is she?
Yeah.
What's she doing in Sydney?
I'm married in
Sydney. Oh, nice.
I'm down there. Yeah.
Oh, lovely. Is she liking it?
I hope so. She settled down slowly and finally.
Nice. It's really cold here at the moment as well.
Okay. So how was the situation there? How's it like? Under control? The pandemic is under control there?
Yes. I work in a hospital. So it's been a bit crazy, but they're starting to roll out vaccines a little bit. So yeah, it's not too bad where we are.
Wow.
Which is good.
So you're working as it?
Pardon?
In hospital? You're working as it? In hospital?
I am a pharmacist in the hospital.
Good. So you have lots of information about the drugs, right?
A little bit. But yeah, yes, it's crazy. It's crazy in India with it at the moment.
Yeah. No, but I'm quite far away from the drugs. I don't know. I don't rely on the drugs at all.
Yeah, yeah. No, that's fair enough. What day recovery are you at?
Yes. Yeah. I mostly believe in the herbal and natural way of healing. Rather being looking for the answer for the allopathy. So
yeah.
I'm kind of that kind of person.
Yeah, no, that's great.
Of course, that's why Ayurveda helped me a lot. Basically, earlier, like since childhood, I'm practicing the yoga and I'm seeing like in Indian family, your mother is a first doctor, right? She knows how to treat her, heal the child. So she knows so many things. So I learned so many things from my mother. And then later on, I get the professional degree in this field. I travel across so many places and learn their natural way to heal many places.
Yeah,
and
awesome.
That's how, yeah. And that's how I become like, okay, now yoga therapy with the yoga and all the approaches, how we can heal ourselves in the natural way. And doing experiment on myself daily basis and then seeing the result on myself and then telling my student that you can do in that way. Either it's to the yoga, shatkarma or pranayam, and either it's home remedies thing, any herbs, any, you know, any spices or anything. First, I experiment on myself and see the result, and then the result is awesome. Even in COVID situation, I couldn't figure out, like, I was thinking, like, I have to take the medicine, the drugs, but I feel like, let me do this thing. Yeah. Let me experiment on myself. Can I heal through the nature or not? And the result is ultimate. Awesome. And I'm really happy. I'm very happy. I'm keenly waiting to share my experience with all the students. And I note it down every day, like what I'm doing to myself and how it's helping me. I'm observing it. And I think if it's successful, I think it would be a great achievement.
Definitely.
In
Ayurveda. Yeah, no, I can't wait to hear about it.
Yeah, me too. I'm ready. But I just want to that it should be completed. I should complete my old course, my old training, yes. And then I'm going to discuss about it.
Yeah, no, that's so let's fair hope
everything would be, yeah, so everything should be very positive and then not COVID positive, but the positive result.
Yeah, yeah, hopefully so.
Yes. So, Mia, I think there is nobody.
Yeah, no,
we can start from. Yeah, okay, so we're gonna start from you. So today, I think Sapta Prakriti, we discuss about it. You can write it down, the Sapta Prakriti, in your notebook. And Sapta Prakriti, S-E-P-T, Sapta Prakriti, P-R-A-K-R-A-I-T-I, Prakriti, Sapta Prakriti, seven types of personality, right? So half of the thing I covered, but I'm going to start again, so you're not going to miss anything. So Sapta Prakriti, seven types of the personality, okay? Seven types of the personality, we discuss about it. Very first personality, like in this whole world, if you are looking like what kind of personality I am, you're going to follow into this seven types of personality. All the people around the, across the world, they follow into the seven types of the personality according to the Ayurveda. Okay. So three types of the personality is the, like one dominant personality and other three is a other four is a combination personality. First three personality is a dominant personality, like one is a dominant, you are born with it, that is your personality, and other combination personality, right? Understand, we are talking about the Vata, Pitta and Kapha, three dosha. You heard about three dosha? Three dosha, no, T-R-I-P-R-I-D-O-S-H-A. Three dosh. Three means three. Dosha means your qualities, your nature, how you look like, your features, your persona, your characteristic, your mental, your physiological body, right? Why you are like this? Because of the three dosha. Okay? It makes you, it forms you, what you are. So, three dosha basically, it's make your body, your mental body, your physiological body, your psychological body and your physiological body. Please pardon me. Okay. So this three dosha is Vata, Pitta and Kapha. Vata, I'm just quickly repeating it. Vata is basically made of the five elements. Have you heard about five elements? Mia, you heard about five elements? Like we heard about fire, air, earth, right? You heard about it, space and water. These are the five elements. So Vata is the composition of the two elements, that is the air and space. Mm-hmm. Air and space, right? And the location of the Vata is below the navel. Below your navel, there is a location of the Vata. Then Pitta is composition of the fire plus water. Fire plus water. Pitta. P-I-T-A, Pitta. Vata. V-A-T-A, Vata. Okay? So Vata composed. Composition is Vayu, air plus space, Pitta composition, fire plus water. And the location of the Pitta in your body, major location, basically it's prevalent entire your body, but the major location above the navel till the chest, towards the chest. So from navel to the chest, this is the Pitta location in your body. Then kapha, K A P H A, kapha. The pronunciation is kapha. The kapha body basically made of the earth plus water. Earth plus water. And location of the kapha is from the chest to the head. From chest to the head. So major location of the kapha. So vata, pitta and kapha, these are the location and they do certain function in the body. For example, vata, all the movements in the body, like how the transportation of the nutrition going from cell to cell, how you are intaking the air, right? Intake of anything, assimilation. These things happen because of the vata. Vata give you mobility, mobility to your body, right? Any movements you are making, your synovial joints, these are movements are going to happen to your body because of the vata. So mobility is happening because of the vata. Then we have pitta. Pitta function is anything which is digestion. Digestion, assimilation, absorption is happening in your body because of the pitta. Then kapha does providing the lubrication, mucus, smoothness, solidity to the body. Okay, this is the function, physiological function of the vata, pitta and kapha in a person. Okay, so now once you understand this, so this is a quick preview, detailed things you can go through. Okay, so Sapta personality is talking about this vata, pitta and kapha. So very first personality is a vata dominant personality. Okay, vata dominant personality. So attribute of the vata, exam, like you are having all the three dosha, right? But imbalance of the three dosha we are talking about here. So vata is dominant, means vata is higher than the rest of the two dosha from the pitta and the kapha. So if vata is higher, so you have certain attributes, certain characteristics, certain physiological and psychological characteristic in your body. So you write it down. Vata dominant personality, first personality, then write it down characteristic of the physiological characteristic of the vata personality. Physiological characteristic of the vata personality, very first characteristic, they are lean. The body type is lean, short and thin. Okay. Very difficult for them to gain the weight. It's very difficult for them to gain the weight. They are very lean, thin body type. Their body type would be lean, thin, and difficulty to gain the weight, right? Their eyes would be short. Okay, feature would be sharp. Their face feature would be sharp. Eyes would be short. Forehead would be small. So this forehead, you can see this area is not widened enough. Okay. So this would be short. And this skin would be dry. Skin dry. And color of the skin would be dusky. Dusky color. Okay. And they have like it's like you can see like undeveloped people, not very much developed, undeveloped. They're born with the vata quality. if we are talking about what the dominant, it means they born with the one prakriti, that is a vata prakriti. So their physiological understand these prakriti resided in the womb of the mother already. So we all the people around the world, they born with the one prakriti. Later on, they get combinated personality later on. But this is the major, the personality which they born with it, which decide their body, physics, and their mind. But if they are working hard, they can change, they combine it with the other things also. We're going to discuss about later on. But this much you understood, physiological characteristic of the Vat. Their hair would be wavy. The hair would be wavy and frizzy. Wavy and frizzy and dry. And psychological characteristic of the Vat personality, you can write it down. There are Hello. Yeah, you can hear me?
Yes.
Basically psychological, they are absent-minded. Okay. Balendra, hi. Hi, Balchan.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay. So, good morning.
Good morning. First class?
Yes.
You joined late, yeah?
I was not aware there is a class at 12 because I was going as per the previous schedule of last week. That was from 10 to 11 okay. And 12 to 1.
So, you know which class is going on right now?
I assume it is Ayurveda class.
Because
you're seeing a lot of
most of the session you missed. Most of the session you missed. So you can go through the YouTube channel and you can follow me there. Okay.
Surely.
My video is recorded. Yeah.
Yes.
So right now we are discussing about the Sapta personality, and we are discussing about the very first personality, Vat. I think you have a little bit idea about the Ayurveda. As you are Indian, right?
I can only understand some words like pit and kapha.
Oh my God. What the pit and kapha? Okay. That's
pit
okay.
Pit is a very general word, but please go ahead. I'm listening. No problem. Thank you.
Okay. Later on, you can follow the recorded videos, right? And and follow it. Thank you.
Yes.
On YouTube, it's a little.
Yes, I saw it. I was not able to understand why Ayurveda videos are coming because I was not aware that it is a part of the curriculum.
It is the part of the students who really want to interested to know about the Ayurveda. So
yes, sir.
I think this is the best opportunity for the everyone. I think 200, 300, they are getting the free classes of Ayurveda. So,
okay.
Chal, yeah. Okay, back to the class. Mia, you can hear me, right? Mia, you can hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. So, yeah, we are discussing about the Vat personality, psychological characteristic. Now, from physiological to psychological, they are absent-minded. They easily learn, easily forget the things. They are get easily bored with the things. They talk fast, very fast. You know, I think you met with the people, they talk very, very, very fast. You cannot understand. And they walk very fast. So talk and walk, they do very, very fast mode. And they are not very clear. Like they always keep confused, keep thinking, keep pondering about too many things. And they don't have the clear vision that what they want in their life. So Vata people, they think a lot. And because of that, they get psychosomatic problems. Mm-hmm. So their mental body is a little bit disturbed, but they're talkative, extreme extrovert, like very social. They have lots of friends because they have the power to persuade the people. Because of the, you know, command over the social gathering.
Mm-hmm.
So they have the, you know, this power to persuade through the words. And though their body is not very much attractive, but their talk is very much attractive. So related to their occupation is also they very do well in the marketing business. Their occupation, what kind of occupation is suitable for them? Marketing, where they need to sell something. Social gathering, hosting anything, a channel or any news channel, whatever, they would be great in the, they are great radio jockey or anchor. They do very well in the, like, helping the society. Like, they would be a great social worker. They can be a leader also because they have the power of the words. But because they are not in clear thinking, they are not having the clear vision, they collapse. They get bored with the easily. They always want new things, new friends, new surrounding. That's why they travel a lot. They're not organized. So these things make them to, you know, make them to lose so many things. They don't have the good family relationship because they are very unstable. They even don't know how they're going to tackle the problems related to the relationship. So instability in the mind come to their body also and come to in their relationship also. If they somehow learn through the technique, there's a many techniques. If they follow those techniques and they control this instability, they can get on the top. They can be a great, you know, successful men and women in their field, the field which we talked about it. Problems, most of the problems, physical and psychological, psychosomatic problems come to them easily. I think you are aware about the psychosomatic IBS, irritable bowel syndrome, right? These are the psychosomatic problems. Then autoimmune disease, again, arthritis, osteoporosis, these kind of problems come to them. Most of the bone-related issues come to them. Another asthma is again the Vata-related issue. Vata is dominant in the people, then they get the asthma also. and somehow kapha, because of the kapha imbalance also the asthma you get. But yes, vat also create this problem, asthma. So these problems, physiological problems, disease disorder, anxiety, panic attack, they feel insomnia, they cannot sleep very well, and mentally they are very active. They are very active, and it's disturbed their physical body also. I think this much is clear till now. Vata people, Vata dominant personality, their physiological, psychological, and their occupation and their problems. Till now it's clear. Mia and Balchandra.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, yes. Yeah.
Okay. Then next personality we gonna take, that is a Pitta personality. The Pitta, you can write it down, the Pitta dominant personality. The Pitta dominant personality, the very first physiological characteristic, they have the moderate body type, medium height. Vata people have short height, hair. Pitta people, moderate body type. Shoulder wider, modern, like it, the shoulder would be wider, forehead would be wider, hair would be silky, thin, shiny. Scalp, the hair scalp in Vata people is dry, but in Pitta people is oily. Scalp of the hair is oily in the Pitta people. Then they have the medium feature, skin color, medium feature, skin color, reddish, pinkish, shiny, and skin type, oily. They have medium to tall height. Okay, medium to tall height. They have not very heavy and not very lean. So it's called moderate body type. Not very heavy and not very lean. So these are the ideal personality. Their physiological structure is very ideal, very handsome. If girl is Pitta, it means she is very beautiful body. She is having it. Boy, very handsome muscles, they are gonna have it. So if Pitta people in the, you know, in the group or in somewhere, you cannot ignore them. They are very handsome and very beautiful personality. They are having it, possessing it. Now their psychological characteristic, they talk moderately and they walk moderately, not too fast, not too slow, moderately, but aggressively also. There is so much aggression. Their pitch, the pitch of the voice would be high. Vata people, they talk very fast. But Pitta people, their talk would be like, pitch would be high, but moderate. You can easily understand what they are talking about it. Okay. They are very organized, very well-planned people. Whatever, for example, they are going somewhere, so they need to plan everything. They're very organized, very, very, you know, punctual people. Discipline. But there's the one problem. They lose temperament easily. They lose their temperament very easily. So if they learn how to control their temperament through the technique, through the practice of yoga and other things, they can do very well in these certain occupation, they have great, they can be a great businessman, great CA, the paperwork, those who handle the paperwork, they are very great in that. All the desk job, they can do very well in that. The things where they require the planning for, like engineers, like they plan everything, automobile thing, most of the engineers, civil engineers, mechanical engineers, where they require the planning, okay? They do very well in these things. And great businessmen, require to plan the structure, how they're gonna execute the planning, how they're gonna buy, what they're gonna sell, everything. So they are very good in that. But the problem area is what? They lose the temperament. And if they are losing the temperament while doing the job and the business, it is the biggest drawback for them. It is a great hurdle in the path of their success. They cannot be a successful person. So they need to control their anger issue, right? They need to know how to manage their anger. Their memory is moderate. It's not like they are quickly learning or quickly forgetting, moderate learning, okay? In relationship, if they don't lose their temperament, they can go very well. But because they lose the temperament, long-term relationship becomes short-term relationship. The problem area, the physiological problem, the disease, disorder, sickness, mostly the skin-related problems, eczema, rashes, itching, hypertension, hyperacidity, and cardiovascular issues. It doesn't mean that Vata and Kapha, people doesn't have these issues. They get these issues also, but Pitta people are more, you know, what we say, they catch more easily these things. Right? Okay. Pitta people catch more easily these things. So it doesn't mean like Kapha people doesn't get rashes or some kind of skin problem. They will get, but the ratio is less. Pitta people get more easily these problems. Acne issue, like mostly people, they have acne on their whole body. These because of the Pitta. Pitta means heat in their body. The heat related problems, any heat related issue is basically Pitta is imbalance in their body. That's why they get these kind of problems. And how are we going to check the Pitta there? By through their talking, how they walk moderately. They walk not too fast, not too slow. They talk normally, moderately. So next is Vata, Pitta and Kapha. So Kapha, K-A-P-H-A, Kapha. Kapha dominant personality now. So Kapha dominant personality, these are the people, their physiological characteristic. They have heavy body type, heavy and wider body type. It's like they are very tall and very healthy, very heavy. Mostly, like the, if you see any person who is very, very tall and very wide, you know, so it means they are Kapha. These people, they have the soft, supple skin, soft and supple, smooth skin. Okay. hair would be thick, heavy. Hair would be thick and heavy. Eyes and eyelashes would be big. Their eyes and eyelashes would be big. They are very soft skin, you know, the like a pillow. Like some people are very soft, so because of the cuff, one of the kaffa make them soft. Color of the skin would be whitish. Color of the skin would be whitish. And their psychological characteristic, the mental body basically, the one word, they are lazy. Okay, they are super lazy. The kaffa people, they don't want to, like a Labrador. They just eat and sleep. They love eating and sleeping. Pitta people, they are very active physically. Vata people, they are active very mentally. But kapha people, they are lazy in both ways. They don't want to think, they don't want to do any activity. They're super lazy. Their memory, difficult to learn the things, but difficult to forget the things also. Okay, difficult to learn the things, same, difficult to forget the thing. Memory is good. If they learn something, it is stored for a longer time. They are very loyal in relationship, very loyal, and extremely introvert personality. They are introvert. They don't socialize much. They are not kind of party person. Vata people, complete party person. They want to do daily party. Pitta people, they're going to organize the party. Kapha people, oh, I'll see, I'll come or not. So kapha people, even they don't want to, you know, use their feet for the dancing even. They are just happy in their environment. They sit in their room and just enjoy it. Yeah. They don't like change. Vata people, they love change. They want change in their environment, in their friendship. Kapha people, oh, not at all. They are attached, completely attached with their rooms, their things. They even name them. They stick to them. And something happened to their things, is a heartbroken. They're completely heartbroken. But very adorable and loyal personality. In relationship, I think you should go for the kaffa people. They are great friends because they don't have much friends around them. So if you become the friend of the kaffa people, you are the world for them. You are the only one who is the world for them. If they fall in love with you, you are in the center. You are the first priority. They cannot think about any other things. They just think about you. So this is the loyalty in the relationship. Vata and Pitta personality very correlate. They go with very, they have the great foundation with the kapha kind of personality. In relationship, if Vata people become friend with the kapha, they amazing relationship, go long-term relationship. Pitta people go with the kapha again. They do wonder in the relationship. But if they Vata and Pitta go in together, dangerous combination. It's the most dangerous combination because Vata people absent-minded, they don't like, and Kapha people, Pitta people, they lose their temperament. But they don't go for the long term. But they are attracted to each other very much. Kapha Kapha doesn't attract you much. They are lazy, slothy. But if you fall in with them, oh, you have to stick with them. You cannot come out easily. They cannot leave you easily at all. They do whatever they need to do to bind to, you know, to bind you in their life. So another thing, these the Kapha personality who go into the depression very easily. These are the people who committed the suicide. These are the people who go into the deeper level of the depression where they have to kill themselves because of the loneliness, because of the, you know, they don't go well together with the social norms. They are mostly in the isolation. They're great now. The profession, if they come out from their laziness, they are great, great creator, like they are a great scientist, researcher, painter, artist, poet, writer. Because these profession require isolation, and Kapha people mostly live in isolation. So any profession which required isolation, they do very well if they come out from their laziness. Okay, so they do very well in these profession. They are great painter, great poet, great writer, great researcher, scientist, and sociopath also. They can be a social killer also. Because somehow it will be the depression and isolation. And so if they come out from these stages of the mind, they can be a great yogi also. Okay? Because the path of the yoga starts from the depression. Once you reach to that deeper level, I think many yogis, they took the yoga once there, nothing else is remaining in their life. Then they decided, okay, now they have to choose the path of the yoga or choose the path of the spirituality. So these are the people, Kapha people, they can be a great yogi. Now, the talk and the walk, they slowly talk and slowly walk. They talk and they walk. They talk slowly and they walk slowly. Like they say, okay, how are you? How you are doing? Some people talk moderately and some people very fast. Okay, what you doing? How's your day? How's your day? Very fast, you cannot understand. So talk, the first is a vat, moderate, pitta, slow, then is a kapha. So the problems related to the kapha people and the disease, mostly they get cold, cough, sinus, laryngitis, these tonsillitis, these are the problems. Cold, migraine, headache, you know, and ear infection, gray hair, premature aging. These are the Kapha related problems. Kapha is also the major problem in the people who lose their eyesight. So if Kapha is imbalanced, they can lose their vision, myopia like, farsighted and nearsighted, both problems. And ear infection, throat infection, tonsil infection, lungs infection, all the problems related to the, from the lungs to the head, all the problems related to the Kapha. Kapha goes imbalanced, and that's how you get these problems. So till now, these three personalities are clear, Mia?
Yeah.
Okay. Any doubt now? We're gonna take the question. Any doubt till from today's session?
No.
Balchandra, any doubt?
Yes, you just, I have written down after I started attending. This is regarding the characteristics of what personality?
We talked about the Sapta personality. Today topic is the Sapta personality, seven types of the personality. So first personality, we discuss about the Pitta. Then second, we discuss about, first we discuss about the Vat. Then second is the Pitta. Now we discuss about the Kapha.
Correct. Kapha. So in the
personality we discuss about.
Correct. So in the Vat personalities, mm-hmm. you said they talk fast and walk fast. And they also think a lot.
Yes, they think a lot.
So isn't it that generally somebody who thinks a lot, he is generally very slow in talking because he always measures his word before he speaks.
Yeah, it can be possible that come into the combination personality, which we're going to talk about tomorrow session.
Okay.
This is the, right now we are talking about the dominant personality. Three is the dominant personality. Four personalities are the combination personality.
Okay. Fine. I have no questions for today's session. So,
okay, thank you, dear. Mia Balchandra, I think from today, we're going to close our session here. Okay, namaskaram. Hope and enjoy tomorrow. Tomorrow is a Sunday, so tomorrow is off. So tomorrow you're going to have off day and enjoy Sunday. And namaskaram. Mangal ho.
Thank you.
Bye, Mia. I hope you feel better.
Yeah, definitely. Bye-bye.
Yeah.